either up or down. Working my way back to Bray now, and that is Hillswick, just down the bottom of the hill to the left. Ah, crack on. Stayed away, which is pretty cool, but yes, up here. So I'll catch you in Yell. So in the background, just behind me, just left the Northern Isles. Toft on mainland Shetland, and now heading to Ulst on Yell. So it's been quite grey, quite windy, but we are heading towards Gutchen once we get to Yell. So I'll catch you further on route and waiting for the sun to come out. Catch you later. So here we are on Yell. Nice lady at the terminal made me a cup of coffee, which was very good. Enjoyed that. And we've got about 17 mile, went about 25k to get to Gutchen. So this is a bit of a funky bus stop, I believe. I'm not quite sure a puffing with the Sex Pistols is the norm. So yes, we got a book of the Queen. I can sit here in my crown and read this book. Ah, yes. Is this another one? Hello. Have you come to join us? Hello. You alright? Hello. Oh, hello. So I'm back to my bus stop, which is more like a mini throne. I'm just making myself a cappuccino. Got my handy little stove here, my Krakow. I've got some chocolate brownies that I got from the local bakery. And this is a good place to take 10 minutes out of the rain. I've even got a comfy chair to sit and watch some pretend TV. So it's a little bit bleak out there, but hey ho, we'll crack on, have this cappuccino, and that will send us on our way. So from the royal throne here at the top of the British Isles, I will catch you laters. fabulous view across to Yell on this high vantage point in Unst, high up in the Shetland Islands. So I'm just leaving the old post office in Yale. So a fabulous place to stay. So Peter really looked after me. Really good little B&B there. And if you ask in advance, then they'll do you a meal, lovely breakfast. So first class, so check out the old post office in Yale. It's right at the ferry terminal to go to Unst and Fetlar. So I'm gonna crack on now. I'm across to Fetlar. And then I'm back across to the mainland. So I'll catch you further on route from Yale. Take care. So rolling on to mid Yale. It's a little bit brighter today. Less wind. Which makes it a bit more pleasurable. If you can make out across the water, that's Unst. Lovely clear day. Fabulous. Moving ahead south. Unst and Fetlar all had a ride around. Really nice, really lovely scenery, and certainly up the east coast of Yale. So when you go to mid Yale, make sure that you take the coast road either when you either go to Yale or when you come back from Yale. So I'm heading to a place called Upper now on the west coast, and hopefully this sunshine will continue, although the rain is forecast a little bit later. West coast, another island. It did start off raining, but now the sun's come out and shown its face, and looks fantastic again. Catch me. So it's a little bit bit rainy in Whalsay, but looks interesting. Looking back across to the mainland, way over there. It's great getting these little ferries that take you across all these different islands. Fabulous. It may be a bit grey today, but it's still fabulous to be out here. So here we are, seems to be a similar theme, back in a phone box, out the wind and the rain. I'm actually waiting for my ferry to take me back to the mainland, or mainland Shetland, having been round Whalsay in the wind and the rain. So I'm going to have some chicken sweet corn soup noodles, just cooking up. My ferry, probably about 40 minutes, it's a little bit of a rusty phone box, but it's nice and dry in here out of the rain, so I'm going to crack on, get some food. Hey ho, welcome to the Shetlands. So here we are back in Lerwick, and thankfully today it's a little bit brighter and there's a bit of sun about, although it's still windy. It's always windy. However, it's all good. Yesterday was pretty damn brutal at times. I was battered by the rain and the wind, and very exposed as you are out here. It was pretty horrendous. Still, there were still some good things to see yesterday. Still sound fantastic. Been up to the far north of the island, been down to the far south, down to Sumbra Head. Been up to Unst and Fetlar and through Yale. Really good. And then across to Whalsay as well yesterday. So yeah, all really quirky. Great place to come and bike pack. I've been doing a bit of wild camping and then a bit of Airbnb, recharge my batteries, have a hot shower, as you do. So it's been all really good. Really, like any time that you come and ride in these kind of places, be it the Highlands, Islands, or certainly coming out to some Shetland, is that you have to manage your expectations. You know, the wind at the times is so strong that it will almost stop you. Even rolling down the hills, it will virtually bring you to a stop, or it will try and wipe you out. You know, yesterday to try and wipe me out twice, but thankfully I managed to avoid that. But if you're a little bit lighter, then it would have been really dodgy. You may well have had to taken refuge in an odd bus shelter, of which there are some. But one of the really important things to remember when you come here is that there just isn't places once you leave the sort of capital, which Lerwick is, to grab yourself a coffee or warm yourself through. So always carry a little micro stove. I carry a tiny little stove, it's called a cracker, and it's ideal. So carry some sort of noodles with you, coffee, so tea, whatever your vice is really, so you can have yourself a warm drink, and it makes a real difference to be able to have a warm drink through you and plough on through the miles. So make sure that you have a little micro cooker and you'll have a fabulous time. I've seen the puffins again, seen the oyster catchers, lovely birds, and then I've had some birds that have been following me all the way along, sort of riding on my shoulder. So it's been great actually. So have a think about it, come to the Shetlands, you know, you'll enjoy it. It's a fabulous place. The hills, it's undulating, they're long and drawn out. I wouldn't say they're steep, but they are long and drawn out, unlike the west coast of Scotland. If you're familiar with that, some of them are very sharp up and down, sort of 13-14% up and so on, whereas here it's not like that. There's lots of 6s and 7s and some 8s, but they go on for quite some time. It's the fact that you're very exposed with the wind, whatever direction they say that the prevailing wind comes from, I can assure you it will hit you from the front, from both sides. But it's all good, and it doesn't detract from what is a fantastic location to come and bike pack. So enjoy your adventures, enjoy your cycling, come to Shetland, experience something quite unique, you'll have a fab time. So take care, all the best, bye bye now.